But here I do see a background with this individual specific to his discomfort in living every day and a remedy to that problem. And there
but this is more than just disenfranchisement. This is a man who clearly had psychological issues. His family knew he had psychological issues. You don't simply look at somebody's YouTube and go, hey, ooh, this is troubling, I'm going to call police, unless there's a history of some sort of behavior that is no longer manageable. Holly Hughes, you've been in this situation, criminal defense lawyer. How do you deal with a young man who is on the verge?
Well, you try very hard. It's exactly what Lou said. You know, you need to be able to get them involuntarily committed and then see, have a workup done on them. What's more interesting to me is I think it's time to have a discussion about legislating some of the gun issues. Now, I'm not against having guns. It's a constitutional right. I own a firearm. That's great. But the disconnect is if there is somebody with legitimate mental health issues who's been institutionalized, who has been diagnosed, who is or should be on medication, is there a way that when you apply for a gun permit, we can give that gun shop owner access to those records? Because they're not going to tell the truth. And the laws that exist right now says you can't put it out there. You've got HIPAA.
This is an ongoing conversation, and it's one that's never going to be resolved. It's got to be about mental health and not firearms. But I'm going to give Brian Claypool the last word because he did stick around. Yeah. Go ahead, Lou.
Deborah, I just want to say one thing in reference to her comments. You know, she's absolutely right. We need to come to the realization that we have this reoccurring problem that involves mental illness. And I've spoken to this numerous times. We have too many different standards. For example, those of us in law enforcement, prior to us obtaining a firearm to carry out our duties, we go through a different screening process, which includes psychological screening. We take Minnesota multiphasic screening, Rorschach, word association. And we have interviews with psychologists and psychiatrists. These are not unreasonable expectations.
They're not unreasonable expectations, but they're expectations that have to start by lawmakers passing laws. That is not going to happen. We have seen this over and over again. Unfortunately, I have to say goodnight to all of you just for a little while because we're going to bring you back. In any event, stand by while we move on. But first of all, a young man who was one of the first at the shooting scene, he saw a young woman who was on the ground. He knew immediately, she wasn't going to make it. You're going to hear what else he saw at the scene of the mass murder in just a few minutes. Stay with us. We've got a lot more
to correct.
We can
this.
Talk, but we have to take action. Lou Palumbo, thank you. Holly Hughes, the murder rate has been cut in half since the early 90s, but there have been no declines in mass shootings. What are your thoughts?
Well, you know, I'm with Lou. I know you keep saying, and you've echoed it many times throughout the night, I don't want to blame anybody. We don't want to blame law enforcement. But we need to do something, Deborah. We need to blame something. And something is a breakdown in our system. It's about time we do start pointing fingers, and not at individual people, but what is the problem in our system? Where is the breakdown? This young man had never been hospitalized, so he didn't pop when they ran federal criminal background for him in order, you know, to get a gun. So what we need to do is say, all right, we know we can't get multiple. We know there's a pharmacological database already because you can't go to Kroger and get, you know, a prescription for one thing and then run down to a different doctor and get a prescription and take it to Publix and get it for the same thing. Those are all linked. If you start trying to do that, they know about it. Databases are already there. Let's start using them to prevent guns from getting into the hands of the mentally ill.
And Jeff Gardier, this is a kid. He wanted to be remembered. Not-